大家好，又欢迎来到这个个人短答技巧的第十一个 video 啦。咁今次呢都是教你哋点样去 expand your answer。咁就之前嗰一集呢就是教你哋点样 expand 呢就是俾 examples 啦。咁就唔经唔觉呢就去到第十一个 video 啦。咁就如果想睇返之前嗰啲 video 呢就可以 click 返上面呢条 link 啦。咁就今次啦，就點樣可以教你點樣可以 expand your answer 咧？其實咧，你會睇呢幅圖咧，你就會估到啦。咁啊，個鼻哥長咗，即係點解咧？其實咧就係教你哋講少少嘅大話嘅。咁點解即係考試要講大話咧？其實咧就係記住啦 ，It's okay to lie if it helps you to give examples to support your answer. You are being judged on your ability to speak English.Not on how truthful you are. 咁啊，記住，其實你考試，無論你係寫文又好，即係講英文又好，其實咧，人哋真係想知道你識唔識得用嗰個語言嘅啫。咁就唔需要太介懷話呢件事係咪真係有發生啊，或者係咪真係個人經歷啊咁樣。咁其實真係點解咧？其實最重要就係令到你容易啲啊。去答題，咁就話如果假如你真係有呢個經歷，或者你真係知道嗰啲答案嘅話，咁其實冇乜所謂嘅，咁你咪照講啦。但係如果你真係未試過，或者你即係你覺得係好難答嘅，咁其實你好似作故仔咁樣去作一啲嘢咧，咁某程度上就係一個小型嘅大話，但係其實就會幫你可以 expand your answer properly 啦。咁我哋一齊睇一睇呢個兩個答案啦。咁啊，呢個題目啦 ，Have you ever had a bad experience at a hotel？ 咁啊，即係話喺酒店有冇一個即係唔好嘅經歷啦？咁有啲同學咧，可能即係唔係住過太多酒店啦，咁於是咧，佢哋就會即係好真心咁樣咧就答咯喎 ，No。I haven't had a bad experience at the hotel before. We actually usually go camping instead because it's much cheaper. I've only been to a hotel a few times. 咁啊，呢個係真噶啦嚇。And it's always been fine. Sometimes the food isn't very nice, but the rooms are always all right.嗱，咁其實咧就條題目就問你有冇試過啊嘛。咁其實尤其是一啲比較 negative 嘅答案咧，就好難。即係 expand 嘅，即係如果你話有冇啊冇喎咁樣，跟住之後你就講咗好似好離題咁，又講 camping 啊，又講其他嘢啊咁樣。咁呢個學生咧，雖然真係真嘅個事情，但係咧相比於student B 呢一個咧講少少大話嘅學生咧，咁佢係低分好多嘅，因為佢冇咩講啊，個 content 唔係好多，因為太真實啦。咁呢個 student B 咧就作咗好多嘢嘅，咁我哋一齊睇一睇佢作咗啲乜嘢啦。咁佢又答 yes 啦，係真係有啲唔好嘅經歷啦。咁佢話 When I was on holiday with my family last year, we had a terrible experience in a hotel in London。咁啊作到去倫敦喎，咁啊有啲啊冇唔知啦嚇。總之佢就即係作咗話佢去英國嘅一個經歷。We had problems with the staff and rooms. 咁佢好快脆咧，就係講咗咧有兩方面佢都好唔滿意嘅。咁啊，同埋當然啦，佢一直都用緊 past tense 啦嚇，咁好小心喺 tenses 方面嘅控制。咁啊，接住咯，咁啊，佢第一方面就唔滿意就係 staff， 第二唔滿意就係間房。咁於是咧，佢就 staff 咧就開始 elaborate 啦。咁啊，呢一度咧就同上一個 video 係一樣嘅，係 expand through 一啲嘅 example 啦，就話咧 firstly。The staff were extremely rude. When we first arrived, there was nobody on reception, and we had to wait for 20 minutes before anybody came to check us in. It was a nightmare. When the staff finally arrived, they were really impatient with us. They then gave us the wrong key and seemed to think that it was our fault.咁佢咧就數佢咯喎，咁啊有啲咩唔好咧？第一啦，冇人 reception 啦，跟住咧又嚟到 check in 咧，就係要等咗廿分鐘啦，跟住咧嚟到跟住有 impatience 啦，有 wrong key 啦，咁啊其實咧就數佢呢啲唔好嘅嘢咧，就一件事啦，又要佢冇人，跟住等完之後又冇，即係嗰個態度好差，又俾錯鎖匙咁一路咁樣作落去咯喎，咁啊接住咧佢之前提及過係啲房唔掂啊嘛，咁啊房有啲乜嘢咧？佢 second。The hotel rooms themselves were the most disgusting hotel rooms I've ever seen. They clearly hadn't been cleaned, as we could see hairs in the sink and on the pillows. I couldn't believe that they hadn't even changed the bed sheets. One of the most basic requirements of a hotel room is that it is clean, and this hotel couldn't even match that standard。咁你會見到咧，佢就係話咧係 disgusting。咁你見到佢用咗個 sentence pattern， the most disgusting hotel room superlative。咁啊，用咗個 sentence pattern 啦。咁 they clearly 亦都用好個 tense 啦，用咗個 past perfect 啦，即係喺佢去嗰陣時咧，就係一個過去式啊嘛。但係喺佢去嘅再之前。咁所以就要用一個past perfect 啦，咁佢用啱嘅，咁啊即係冇啦 ，hadn't been cleaned as we could， 用 past tense 啦 ，I couldn't believe 啦，跟住之後咧，其實數佢兩樣嘢嘅，第一咧就係頭髮啦，喺個浴室度啊，同埋喺枕頭度啊，喺個星即係嗰個星盤度，咁同埋咧就係仲有乜嘢咧，連床單都冇換嘅，咁即係其實佢數佢兩樣嘢啦。咁啊，跟住就你會見到亦都係用咗一個 superlative 啦 ，one of the most basic requirements 啦，佢講到個 S 啦，因為其中一個最重要嘅條件就係乜嘢咧，要乾淨啊嘛。咁啊 ，this hotel couldn't even match that standard 咁樣講啦。咁你見到佢咧用咗一啲適當嘅句式啦，亦都即係啲 tenses 係一直都係用緊 past tense 啦。咁同埋咧就係即係啲 grammar 同埋佢嗰個 structure 都好好。咁去到最尾咧，佢 in the end we checked out of the hotel and found somewhere else to stay. Luckily we were able to get a refund on the rooms, but it was still an awful experience. 咁你條題目咧就係話係 bad experience 啊嘛，咁佢又轉咗少少個字啦，佢話係一個 awful experience 啦。咁啊，於是 echo 翻咧就係佢冇再重新講話咩事咩事啦，但係佢話係即係講翻可以 check out 啊，可以 refund 啦，但係總之就唔開心啦。咁就完全咧係答咗呢一條嘅題目，雖然咧就有少少假啦嚇，啲嘢即係講得咁誇張啦嚇，但係就考英文啊嘛，咁佢就真係。用到英文，用到啱嘅 tenses， 亦都好嘅句式，然後跟住表達咗一啲唔好嘅經歷啦。咁啊，又嚟第二條題目咯。What do you like to do in shopping malls？ 咁啊，呢條題目咧，亦都係啦。咁就呢個題目就容易啲嘅。咁啊 ，shopping malls 好多人都去噶啦。咁就但係咧，就有啲學生話：，我好憎 shopping malls 嘅。咁於是用咗好 negative 嘅答案咧，於是就講唔到落去啦。咁我哋就睇下兩位同學咯。一個咧就好負面，就我真係唔中意嘅，咁啊講唔到。咁另一邊咧，就呢位同學咧就話：我好中意 shopping mall 嘅。咁唔知係真係假啦，但係某程度上咧，佢就真係可以去講得好長。咁我哋先睇一睇一位即係好真心去答呢條題目，佢唔中意 shopping mall 嘅答案啦。咁佢就 I actually hate shopping malls, so I try to avoid them as if possible. I find them really boring, especially when I don't have any money to spend. Sometimes my mother forces me to come to the shopping mall with her. It's so dull.If she lets me, I just sit on the bench and play on my phone, waiting for her to finish. 咁其實佢不斷都係講話好悶啦、啊，好悶啦、啊，同埋佢冇錢啦、啊。咁於是佢就唔中意 shopping mall。咁跟住之後咧，但係題目係 What do you like to do？ 咁啊，基本上佢係有答嘅。咁佢話中意喺個 shopping mall 度即係玩手機。咁就呢、這個都好真嘅答案。好多人都唔中意 shopping mall 行街噶嘛。尤其是嚇咁啊，有啲同學啦，咁另外呢位同學咧就作咗好多嘢啦，咁啊即係撒咗好多啲句式落去啦，咁佢就話咯shopping malls are busy places where people from all walks of life come together。好啦，這個、呢個咧我特登即係 highlight 咗俾你哋紅色啦，就係呢一個咧，即係意思咧，就係一個 phrase 啦，好好學嘅，好好用嘅 phrase 啦，就係一定係 people from all walks of life， 即係意思咧，形形色色各種各類嘅各種類型嘅人咧嘅人咁嘅意思啊。都中意去嘅咁樣，咁啊即係嗱呢個句式可以背一背佢啦。好多時即係唔同地方嘅人啊，唔同形式嘅人，咁好多時都用到嘅。There are two things about shopping malls that I really enjoy。嗱呢一個句式我都覺得係值得學嘅，因為咧就第一啦，可以某程度上係壓下啲句即係時間啦嚇，就等你可以諗啊嘛。咁啊有兩件事我好中意，咁有兩件事我好認同咁樣，其實就 there are 開頭啦，用 there are 即係有兩件事情我好中意嘅，就係 shopping in the sales and browsing the very expensive shops。咁佢就講咗咧，佢有一開始就講咗佢有兩樣嘢，佢覺得好中意嘅，即係條題目啦 ，do 做啲乜嘢。 咁啊，佢做好啦，咁啊，佢又講咯，即係大減價嗰陣時 shopping， 咁啊，講翻呢個第一個嘅 elaboration 啦。Shopping in the sales in Hong Kong can be very exciting, especially in the run up to Chinese New Year in February. The shops become very busy, full of people trying to find the best buys, and I thoroughly enjoy the bustling atmosphere.Sometimes people can get a bit pushy and competitive. That's annoying, but it's all part of the fun. 咁啊，有幾個 phrases 都值得學噶啦，例如好似 in the run up to 一個 festival 或者個 event 啦，即係解咩咧？就嚟臨近咁嘅意思啊，即係就到咁嘅意思啦。The shops become very busy, full of people 啦。呢度啊 ，find the best buy 咩意思咧？即係 best buy 即係意思 the bargaining， 即係好。Find the bargain 即係意思咧，啲好抵買嘅嘢啦。咁呢個又係值得學啦。咁啊，呢一個咧，呢個係 thoroughly 咧係解，即係好徹底，亦都係值得學啦。即係如果係 very completely 咁嘅意思啊，即係非常之享受呢一個 bustling， 亦都係啦。如果你想講 busy， 可以試下用 bustling atmosphere， 即係意思好繁忙嘅氣氛。咁啊，佢咧有少少講咗啲唔開心，即係有啲 pushy， 即係例如。太好啦，啲人好逼啦，好 competitive 啦，好擠，即係好擠逼或者好即係競爭性好大，好似搶嘢咁啦，咁都係好 annoying 嘅。咁呢幾個字咧都有少少負面嘅。咁啊，好快脆佢就話 ，but is all part of the fun。咁頭先我打星嗰幾個字咧，都係即係一啲值得學嘅 phrases 啦。無論係作文或者係即係講英文咧，都會係可以用到嘅。Another thing that I find enjoyable about shopping malls is having a look in the very expensive shops. 即係話咧，睇啲好貴嘅鋪頭。There's no way that I'd be able to buy anything from them. I'm not really rich enough, but I still love looking at all the beautiful clothes and jewels that I would buy if I had the money. 嗱，呢一個咧句式咧就係咩咧？就係用 conditional to 啦。咁就係話咧，就係呢個係咩咧？就係佢係 I would buy if I had the money， 即係話如果我咧有錢就會買啦。咁其實短短好短嘅句式，但係呢一個係一個 conditional to 啦，即係一個假設嘅狀況啦。咁你會見到佢係用一個過去式啦，唔係話佢以前買，而係代表用一個過去式，係用一個 if sentence 啦，就係一個 conditional to， 係一個假設性。如果我有錢，我就會買，即係換言之，佢冇錢買唔到而家咁嘅意思。咁啊 ，it amazes me that some people are able to spend tens of thousands of dollars on a dress。咁你會呢個我都覺得係可以值得。就是说啊，这个也是一个英文的 phrase， 就是说很多很多钱的意思咯。Tens of thousands of dollars on a dress. In my experience, shopping malls are an exciting place to be, whether or not you have money to spend. 那么这个也是一个句式啦，就是就算你有钱也好，没钱也好，都是一个很 exciting place。那么回应回呢，就是说呢，他是做些什么了，那他呢主要是做什么呢？就是他是即是在里面即是买东西啦，那么同埋呢就会是即是看那些行去看那些很贵的铺头的意思了。看了剛才那兩個的答案，那你會發覺呢， second answer is clearly better. 為什麼呢？ Because there is more to say. If the examiner asks you what you like or dislike about something, you can't just say nothing. 記住人家問你喜不喜歡一些東西，就不要說我沒有東西喜歡或者沒有東西不喜歡。其實就會即因為這樣你會沒有辦法去用你英文去 elaborate 一些答案。所以呢就是人家問你一些東西，你就嘗試記住呢，就講少少大話，作少少故仔，然後呢就 show off 你的英文，這樣呢才能夠高分的，這樣才可以 expand 到你的 answer。 所以 it is sometimes better to lie about your opinion of something so that you can give a longer or more detailed answer。 咁當然啦，如果你真係有呢個經歷嘅話，咁其實你咪好容易講咯。咁但係有時有啲嘢係冇人嚟問你嘅話，你可能真係冇嘅話，咁唔好怕嘅，就即刻好似故仔咁樣作翻出嚟，只要講到落去就得噶啦。好啦，咁啊 conclusion 啦嚟到，咁啊記住第一點啦，就係 you don't have to tell the truth in your exam， 即係唔係一定要下下都一定要真相。 即係將你真正嘅你生活嘅經歷啊或者之類要講出嚟嘅。And you can lie about your experiences and your opinions in order to give a better, more detailed answer。咁而當你幾時需要講大話咧，即係或者即係唔係講一啲真實嘅嘢咧，其實基本上就為咗你要答到一個詳細啲嘅答案，唔係真係要你講大話，而係只係希望你英文能夠講得，即係用英文去表達得長少少，可以講到多啲嘢。咁啊，記住 subscribe 啦，同埋俾個 like 我啦。咁啊，所有嘢咧都會收錄喺我個網站嘅。咁如果想睇啲 video 可以改善你嘅英文作文啊，或者其他嘅我嘅英文頻道嘅 video 咧，就可以 click 以下呢兩個啦。